Yes, good morning, children. Today we are going to see the next part, that is of fuels. In last video we have seen about the mineral ore and some important ores in that, all iron, manganese, aluminium, copper and their uses, their types, all things. Today we are going to see the next part, that is of fuels. So what is meant by fuels, children, and which natural resources do we use as a fuels? So various substances which we are using in day-to-day life for generating energy, these substances are called as fuels. So these substances which we are giving energy, that is known as a fuels. So the fuels, they are found in a three types, that is of solid, liquid and gases. So one by one discuss solid, liquid and gases. What are their uses, what are their types, how we are getting this from? All things we will discuss here. Yes. Now, next, coal. You know that coal, it is a solid fuels which we are using for many, from many years, and it will take to form the millions years ago. Yes. So here, the millions years of ago, the forest got buried underground as a result of certain natural events in that. So if forest get buried in that, the plant, animals, all they are in there. So layer of that soil is there, so get deposited on them, and due to the very high pressure and the heat from the earth, they get transferred into the fuels. So the coal thus form remains after those dead plants and animals. That is why coal is said as a fossil fuels, from which we are getting from dead animals, plants from there, and it will take 1,000 million years for formation of this coal. So the coal is found in the mines. Here they have shown these all there, how these dead plants and got buried under due to the high pressure and heat, it will get transferred into the this coal. So coal is found in mines, peat, lignite, bituminous coal and anthracite coal. So these are various types of coals. So the anthracite, it is the highest grade of the coal, in that more amount of coal is present. Now coal is in that storehouse of carbon, that's, you know that. So it will burn, you will get heat energy. Again, we use as a fuel for this. So again, these were used as a fuel for thermal power plant, running the boilers, and in old day they are using in railway engine. So coal is also used as a fuel for cooking, also for baking the bricks which we are using for the construction in large amount. Again, which were the, they are for making the gaseous fuels, producer gas, water gas also are obtained from the coal. So coal as an energy resource contributes greatly to the industrial development. That's why coal is very, very important fossil fuels. Yes. Now, next we'll discuss, it is about the how the mineral oil and natural gas are formed. So here three pictures, they are shown formation of mineral oil and natural gas. So here, so millions of years ago, if you are seeing, there are so many living animals in the oceans, but now in 1,000 years their number is reduced, and at present there is less number or no number of the animals in there. So here the difference is like this. So at present we are getting the mineral oil and natural gas from this ocean by the help of this machine. I am sending after the video of this, you can see how we are getting these all things. Now, next page, it is of mineral oil and natural gas. So, mineral oil, if you are seeing, so this is of the liquid fuels. Yes, this is liquid fuel. So, mineral oil is a liquid fuel by the decomposition of organic substance buried underground. So, millions of years ago, in the day, in the sea, so dead organism sank on the bottom of the sea. Again, in the bottom of the sea, here the layer of sand, soil, they can collect it. Again, due to the high pressure and temperature, these dead organisms were transferred into the mineral oil. So these underground mineral oil is extracted to oil wells, and mineral oil is found mainly in oil sand, shale, sandstone, limestone at the depth of 1000 to 3000 meters. So these mineral oil is known as a
पेट्रोलियम और क्रूड ऑयल. सो दिस पेट्रोलियम इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ मेनी हाइड्रो कंपाउंड्स, हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. इन दैट इट कंटेन्स ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन एंड सल्फर्स. येस. सो द पेट्रोलियम इट इज एक्सट्रैक्टेड थ्रू ऑयल वेल्स एंड रिफाइंड बाय द फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन एंड सेपरेट देयर अदर कंपोनेंट. सो इन दैट वॉट इज प्रेजेंट, सो पेट्रोल इज देयर, गैसोलीन इज देयर, डीजल इज देयर, नैफ्था इज देयर, केरोसिन इज देयर, लिब्रिकेटिंग ऑयल्स आर देयर, टार्स आर देयर. सो दीज दे आर ऑब्टेनिंग फ्रॉम दिस पेट्रोलियम ओनली. So they are used as a fuels and production of dyes, pesticides, perfumes, artificial fibers. These all are made from this petroleum. Now, next it is of natural gas. So it is a gaseous fuel. So this is again important fossil fuel. It is found associated with the petroleum underground oil wells. Some places as a natural gas alone also. So the main component of the natural gas, it is a methane, ethane, propane, butane. They are present in small proportion. Now natural gas is formed from the remains of organism buried deep underground, and they are again subjected to high temperature and pressure. Again these fuels carried out over a long distance by means of gas pipeline. If gas pipeline is absent, that time they can transfer under high pressure in compressed manner. Yes, means CNG and LNG. So these are compressed natural gas and liquefied natural gas. So this makes them possible for transporting this gas. Now what are the characteristics of the CNG? So it can catches fire easily. No solid waste remain after the combustion. Carbon dioxide and water, they are formed in small quantities. Other pollutant, they are not produced. They can transport easily and combustion can be controlled easily. Yes. Next, the fossil fuels, they are preserved remain after the dead organism in the rocks also. So these are the existence of left by organism got buried billions of years ago, and these will get the coal and stones from that we are getting these all fossil fuels. Yes. Now next year, yes. So nowadays, if you are seeing the demand of fuels has increased due to the rapidly increase in the population. But if the reservoirs are there, these are limited. So it is becoming difficult to meet this increased demand. So they are finding this can create the energy resources, and they are finding alternative for this fuel. So if in old days, if you are seeing, they we are using the cycles for transporting, and we are going on this only. But nowadays, if you are seeing in one home, we are having four vehicles, along that again one car is there. So they are increasing this demand. And due to that, these mineral oil and coals are limited. So they are finding the alternative. So they are here alternative hydrogen, biofuels, methanol, wood alcohol, ethanol, green alcohol are some of the alternative fuels. Yes. So now this is next again forest fuel. Yes, we'll discuss this forest fuel. So what is meant by forest and what are their uses? So forest is very, very important natural resource which we are getting so many things from the forest. First we'll see what is meant by forest. So extensive area of land that is covered by variety of the plant is called as forest. So it having there in natural habitat, no means only plant is not there in that. So animals are there, microbes are there. Yes, so in all things in their forest, about 30% of land is covered by the forest. So the forest performs both function, that is protective and productive function. So in that protective function of the forest, we will discuss first to reduce the velocity of water flowing over the land. It is very important. So to prevent soil erosion, to help the pollution of water into ground, again to control the flood, to reduce the rate of evaporation, to protect the wildlife, to maintain the balance of atmospheric gases. So these all the protective function of the forest. So this helps to maintain the quality of the our environment. Because of the all variety of the plants are there, they can control all the atmospheric gases in there. Yes. Now next it is of, next we'll see. what is the productive function of the forest? Right. Yes. So from the forest we are getting the medicinal plants. Yes, in that adulsa, beam, neem, periwinkle, these all we are getting cough, cold, diarrhea, fever, cancer. For this we are using this type of the medicinal plant. Again we are getting the wood from it, which is durable, which are firewood we are using for the furniture. In that neem is there, yes, babul is there, so which we are using for the farming implements, furniture and other articles making or for construction also. Again forest wealth includes the fibers which we are getting, paper, rubber, gum, aromatic substances. Again some oils which we are getting for perfumes, the different type of flowers, sandalwood is there, oils are there for making the soap, cosmetic, essence, sticks. So this which we are getting from the forest. Again from forest we are getting the fruits, bulbs, roots, honey, sealing wax, dyes, all which we are getting from the forest. So forest is again very very important natural resource for us. So next video we will discuss about the oceanic resource. Today we will stop here. Thank you.